Good afternoon to everyone. I would like to invite all the guests and spectators to be seated as our major production will begin shortly.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Exhibiting our talents will grow up definitely and will be citizens of our beloved nation. Tomorrow, we may grow up and achieve great success, name and fame, as well as high human rights. But on the other hand, we need to be good human beings also and make this world a better place to live in for all. Education is about far more than what happens within the four walls of a classroom. We feel proud in saying that the talents we display here today is sufficient to say that we have the potential to become worthy citizens of our country. Undoubtedly, we are very fortunate to have such teachers, trainers and instructors who will recognize our talents. If this infrastructure and teachers are the two resources available to the school, then definitely us students are the third ones. One of the joys of being part of the annual function is to draw that creative, academic and sporting potential out of our students. We are all gathered here on this annual day to motivate and inspire young minds to showcase their talents. This is highly important occasion for everyone. It is because of that, apart from the fact that this celebration highlights our school's continuous success in the areas of education. It is always a pleasure to be called as young minds of today and responsible citizens of tomorrow. We students and the whole of our dedicated teachers team appreciate the efforts put in by the parents. So here we feel privileged to extend our warm welcome to all the dearest parents who have constantly extended their support and love to all prospects of the school and each faculty member. We do cherish your partnership and collaboration in all endeavors of our life. We treasure your love and concern towards our institution, which is our second home. Your esteemed presence amidst in the air, I would like to welcome all the teachers, staffs and students who are an integral part of this institution. I request all for your kind cooperation throughout this program and making it a grand success.
Robin, your jewels, my lady.
Never. A lady as fair as yourself has no need of trinkets like these. Your natural beauty shines far more brightly.
Don't be so ridiculous. This is no time for jokes.
Be quiet, Gerald.
Yeah.
Farewell, lovely lady. Have a safe journey.
The sheriff will hear of this. You will stretch your necks.
For now, let's go stretch our stomachs. I'm starving and we've got something to celebrate.
Yes, now we will be able to give a large donation to the teachers when you go in.
Hi, my friend. A worthy cause. Poor souls. Overworked and underpaid, yet always cheerful. An example to us all.
Outlaw's hands. Young Loskley was robbed of his title and home, living only forest in which to roam.
His heart to a noble young lady belongs, but she's held by the sheriff, and all hope seems gone. Will now misfortune turn into evil from good? No, his duty's utmost is our Robin Hood, to undo all the bad the sheriff stands for. He just robs from the rich to give back to the poor.
Again, wait till you hear.
Spending this on necessities.
Right. Guards,
Get those posters up quickly. I want that scoundrel found.
And he wears a hood, sire.
Why don't you go and offer yourself as target practice for my archers? Oh, wait, come back here. I hate to say it, but I have need of you. I want you to disguise yourself as one of this rabble here and see what you can find out about Robin Hood's whereabouts. I have a cunning plan to rid myself of Robin Hood. People's champion once and for all. Shut up! What have you in the stocks? My deputy should be able to find out the whereabouts of Robin's forest and his secret password. Meanwhile, I will start chopping down all the trees in Sherwood Forest, leaving him no place to hide. And he'll keep my castle in locks for years. Ha ha ha! What? Or it's extra man for a month. When I have Robin Hood, I will think of some exquisitely painful punishment for him. And that will be the star attraction of the party I have planned to celebrate my victory. Ah!
Sire, I heard you were looking for a jester.
Indeed. I need to keep a sense of humor with all this stress.
Well, what did one cannibal say to the other while they were eating a clown? Does this taste funny to you?
Take him away! That's criminal!
Please take this. I'm sorry it's not more.
God bless you, Lady Marian. You lot are always complaining about not having any money. Here's a chance to get some. 100 crores. That's no one interested, eh? Well, I'd better get started on shopping now. Gracious forest. 3 fellas, please.
I thought you asked for 3 fellas. There are only 2.
Out of my way. I can see. I'm going to have to think of some more taxes for you to pay me.
How about taxing the air that we breathe?
Simon's right. That's about the only thing left to tax.
That's an excellent idea. I'll work on it. For now, I'll just double the tax on grain.
Robin Hood will never stand for that.
Anyone found helping that outlaw will suffer. Terrible punishment, which I will thoroughly enjoy inflicting. I've warned you already.
What are we going to do? She'll destroy the forest and we won't have any wood.
We can't pay all the taxes now. If she doubles the tax on grain, we'll all starve.
Why did we should have to go and fight in the crusades? Nothing's been the same since he left.
I'd love to get my hands on the sheriff, but she does not have a guard around her.
What? He's got his spies everywhere.
I thought Simon was the pie man. Why is the sheriff selling pies? What sort are they? Shepherd's pies? Or mince pies? Or cottage pies? or Cumberland pies, or sausage pies, or sausage pies with diced onions and a delicate hint of parsley and sage, or...
Shut up!
From the town, tucked away in the green, is Robin Hood's band, faithful, honest, and keen. They want to see justice on again, so they hope, and they pray, and they fight, and they train.
Thank you.
Sheriff Beaker knows?
We've come to help.
Welcome, friends. Welcome to Sherwood.
Some more goodies, chaps. These remind me of my darling Marion. So beautiful, so bright and precious.
What is she done?
But we'll have to arrange for them to go to those in need.
There's plenty of them, Robin.
The sheriff's trying to starve us and to betray you, Robin. But she'll never make us tell.
We want to join you, Robin, and be merry men.
The more, the merrier, I say. It makes a chap proud to have fine followers like all of you. If we stick together, we'll win in the end. We won't give up. We'll fight them in the beaches.
Yes.
We'll fight them among the elms.
Yes.
It doesn't matter that we've got so little. Remember, from little acorns to big oak trees grows. The sheriff's barking up the wrong tree if he thinks he can stop us now. We won't rest until justice walks this land again.
The village folk are hungry, the village folk are sad. They all agree that things have really never been so bad. They haven't any money, the sheriff's people grab. They need aid for a true friend. Perhaps one in heaven. See, when you see the villagers, their earnest, heartfelt cry is, when the chips are truly down, you need some decent friars.
Looks like a fine place for a picnic.
Pop the basket down and let's tuck in.
Don't use that word.
What? Pop?
No,
tuck.
It's enough to keep you off your food. Well, maybe not.
I'm so hungry. I haven't eaten since lunchtime.
Terrible, shocking. Not good for you. But lunch was only half an hour ago.
Little friars should be seen and not heard. Have a chicken leg.
No, thank you. They are foul.
Oh, I shouldn't laugh on an empty stomach.
You don't do anything on an empty stomach.
Only on an empty head.
Just ignore them. We won't let them spoil our lunch.
He seeks to lead us.
Seeks to lead us? Seeks to lead us? us more, like bleed us dry.
I think we need to find a more secluded spot. All this shouting will give me indigestion.
He loves me.
Oh, Robin, someday we will be together. And until then, we'll just have to be satisfied with little glimpses of each other. And I never know when you might be watching me. So I must look my best at all times.
Your hair is so shiny since you started using that new proactive shampoo. I'll need to wear sunglasses when I comb it.
And your hands that don't do dishes are as soft as your face.
For your wild, green, hairy boyfriend. Forget to say the password, hood, and then wink 3 times, okay? The innkeeper will make sure it gets to Robin. I just want him to know how much I miss him, and that I'd do anything to see him again soon, even for a moment. I'd long to see his face again, and I'm sure he'll find a way.
Ah, what is she like?
Oh, he's so handsome. I could fancy him myself.
And he's rather clever and good and fit.
I prefer Will Scarlet. He's a songwriter. That's what I call a real man. So sensitive.
Oh no, I prefer Little John. He's so big and strong. You can tell he works out.
Works out? Oh, out in the forest you mean? It must be all that fresh air.
Like I've gotten ahead?
Come on, we've got work to do.
Chirp, chirp. Oh no, where shall we go now?
I don't know. Nowhere seems to be safe.
And caring of the creature's need, and Friar is wanting a good feed.
Right. This should be far enough for bright eyes. Set it down, little brothers.
Us a picnic, any ginger beer?
I'm afraid we haven't enough to share.
How true, brother?
Brothers, you seem to be getting into some bad habits. Allow us to help you out of them. Come on, chaps.
3 cheers for Robin Hood.
Madam, I can take you home now for only 5 roods.
Thank you.
People are gathered. Contestants are here. Sheriff's Plan B started off with a cheer. Fun and excitement are felt in the air, but all under it hides a terrible snare. For love of a lady, Rob casts off all fears, so let's hope this thing does not end in tears.
Your five-line necklaces here. Lights up in the dark. Don't lose your children. Beautiful necklaces. Only two groats. Come on, folks. For only two groats. Get your five-line necklaces and many other ornaments.
Pheasant tonight. Next contest.
excellent shot. I expect you to get lots of practice in Sherwood Forest. Robin Hood, seize him. I knew you wouldn't be able to resist a challenge. On the chance, kiss the hand of fair Lady Marianne. So I finally trapped you. Take him away until I decide what to do with him. Lock him up and bring me the key.
Oh, Robin, it's all my fault. I should have never said how much I wanted to see you. I should have realized what you were up to, you sly old fox.
You're so beautiful when you're angry. But less of the old, my dear. I don't mind the foxy. You know, you mustn't blame yourself. If you can compete with an evil genius. Though, you must know, Marianne, that everything I do it for you.
Sire, are you still looking for a tester? What do you call a cow in an earthquake? A milkshake.
Ha ha ha! That's wonderful!
Which public school did Robin Hood go to?
I don't know. Which public school did he go to?
Arrow. Get it?
You're hired!
The sheriff's plan B did indeed come to pass. Will the land now be left in such mean, grasping hands? And what will we be proud of? The merry band? A fair lady whips her love lives at a stake. Oh, a sad sight it is to see a herd prey.
Finding a way. Speaking of habits, we have come to bring comfort to the lady. Please leave us so that we can pray.
Marion, it's me, Friar Tuck. Lock the door. We haven't got much time. I have got a plan to rescue Robin, but you will have to be very brave.
Anything for Robin.
You love him that much?
Oh, yes.
Are you sure he deserves your love? Isn't he just a common thief?
No. He only takes back what's already been stolen by the sheriff with his unfair taxes. He keeps nothing for himself. He doesn't want to steal, but he just won't let the poor starve. No one else will stand up for the sheriff.
What about King Richard?
He's a good man, but he's not here. He should have never gone away. Robin had no choice, and now look what's happened.
I see. Try not to worry, Marion. We have to hurry. Here's my plan.
Yuck! Disgusting! But for Robin, I'll do it. Quick! Hide behind there!
Marion, why did you lock the door?
With an outline of the castle, one can't be too careful.
I thought you were in love with that rascal of Robin of Locksley. Or should I say, locked up?
A girl can be so easily fooled. He looked all right outdoors, but he just doesn't look good in a dungeon. You'd look wonderful in a dungeon.
Too kind, my dear, too kind.
And you're so clever. No one could pull the wool over your eyes.
If you've got it, flaunt it.
You're so right. I'd like everybody to see you for what you really are. So I thought I might make you something special to wear for your big party. I'll need to take some measurements, though.
I'm sure that could be arranged.
Or perhaps I should just make it Superman size. I'm sure that will fit, but not over his big head. Just to be safe, slipper jacket off, and I'll pop this round here. Lovely. Keep your arms up a moment. There, all done.
What would it be like?
That will be a surprise.
Ooh, I like surprises.
Good. Because you're going to get a really big one very soon. Arrivya.
Right. Well, I'll go then.
Be quick. Bring him here. Oh, Robin, my love.
Marion, I seem to have forgotten something. As the real winner at the tournament today, I think I deserve to kiss your lovely hand.
Ah! I mean, I haven't washed them for hours.
I'll take my chances.
No, I couldn't. It wouldn't be fair.
But I insist. Unhand her, you cat!
Richard the Lionheart, and I command you
to stop this fighting.
Friar, I mean, sire.
At last, I'm back from the Crusades, and I've seen enough fighting to last a lifetime. People of Nottingham, don't we all want the same thing?
Yes!
A safe, warm place to live, and a good education.
You should try school.
Don't we all want to be free, to live in safety?
Yes!
Don't fight, unite!
Don't fight, unite!
Because of your greed, you have caused a great misery to my people. Take her away.
With pleasure, Your Majesty.
Thank you.
you all, esteemed guests, dignitaries, and friends. It was a great pleasure for both of us to be the host of the show. Before signing off, I would like to call upon the middle school coordinator, Ms. Susan Upadhyaya, for a vote of thanks.
All, on behalf of all students and staff, I'm glad to be standing here to express my vote of thanks. I thank our school principal, Ms. Sanja Adhikari, for always supporting and guiding us. Extended thanks go to Vice Principal, Ms. Angela Kama, for your valuable presence and support. Huge appreciation to our school head, Dr. Namrata Sakrani, for guiding and supporting us through the event. Many thanks to the coordinators and teachers for working hand in hand to make the event successful. Thank you to the directors of the play, Mr. Vivek and Ms. Suchita. Humble gratitude to the administrative staff for their continuous support. Thanks to the jeweler staff for ensuring cleanliness through nooks and corners and for the availability of the resources at the right place. Thank you to the IT department for the support provided. I would like to extend my thanks to all the individual event in charge for working tooth and nail to prepare students for the event. Thank you, participants, for your delightful performance. I would also like to thank each and every one of you for being here and making this day wonderful and memorable to all. Thank you all. I'd like to call Ms. Karen to conclude the show.
I just want, on a personal note, we have been working with these students very hard. And we have about 180 performers here. I think they deserve a round of applause. The choir, who did an excellent job. Thank you, choir. Our wonderful little dancers. Please clap for them. And also our actors. I think they deserve a standing ovation. Don't you think, parents? 180 performers on stage. Thank you.